Philippine shares spared from the bloodbath across Asia, the main index staging a recovery after falling to a six-month low on Monday. The PSEI is now back at 7,000 level after gaining almost 3% or over 200 points. Value turnover also reached 9 billion pesos or 9.6. Regina Capital Development Corporation says investors turned to bargain hunters, with many looking ahead to the U.S. Federal Reserve's next monetary policy decision later this week. We're now joined by Mr. Mark Santarina of Global Link Securities. Good afternoon, Mark. Welcome to the show.
Hi, Stan. Good afternoon.
Mark, we're currently trading under wartime volatility, the so-called volatility, with many issues still ending in the red, even as we were already battered since last week. The PSEI moved up, though, and it's back above the 7,000 level. Now, how was today's market action, especially that rally at the last minute? What did we miss?
The buying at the end of the market is a little bit of a surprise.
Yeah.
But you know, the market has been down for how many trading days now? Mm-hmm. So I think the resurgence of another variant could be another factor as well. We also saw our neighbors in Asia heading towards a downtrend as well. Plus, today, the foreign investors are still debt sellers in the market.
All right, Mark, in this sort of market free fall, the PSEI appears to be searching for a new support. How deep do you think this bloodbath would go, given the unavoidable inflationary pressures of rising fuel prices, commodity prices, and the prolonged Ukraine-Russia conflict?
Yes. Should uncertainties persist, the market may find its next footing at 6,600 in the near term and perhaps 6,400 in the medium term.
All right. Along with rising fuel and commodity prices is, of course, demand for increases in wages, which, when approved, will hit labor-intensive businesses. I mean, is the market even pricing that in right now, and all eyes are just on higher production costs due to inflation or fuel price increases as it is?
Yeah, market participants are carefully monitoring the pass-through impact of higher oil prices to inflation. Assumptions of daily wages may increase in NCR, you know, as much as 470. However, do not yet include the second round effects of inflation on transport fares and production costs. So while wage increase may improve, mm-hmm. purchasing power of consumers, you know, mm-hmm. will just offset the rising cost of goods.
All right, corporate stories now. Integrated Microelectronics Incorporated temporarily shutting down its plant in Shenzhen, China, due to the COVID situation there. The China plant said to account for 10% of output. Now, how is this going to affect bottom lines for IMI?
One week probably will be not a huge deal for IMI, but the possibility of lockdowns increase the risk of supply chain interruptions mm-hmm. and logistic issues. So even if the factory doors are open and regular working hours are restored.
All right. Now, Mark, pending any changes, of course, this week, Bank of Commerce will begin conducting its IPO tomorrow. That's March 16, in time for a March 31st target listing date, with a final offer price of about 12 pesos per share for this issue. Is that attractive enough?
It's priced at a discount from 12.50, mm-hmm. you know, plus it's a San Miguel company. No? So I believe there's still demand for this IPO given the current market conditions.
All right. Lastly, how optimistic are you about this debut, as well as, of course, all the other IPOs in the pipeline going public under extremely volatile times, Mark?
Yeah. So we see the past performance of recent IPOs. So it's really very challenging to conduct an IPO in this period. Mm. I think potential investors will be weighing inflationary effects on disposable income, which will be used to reinvest in the IPO. Actually, I'm looking forward to the Raslag IPO, you know, because it's, you know, another renewable energy play.
All right. On that note, thanks a lot, Mark Santarina of Global Link Securities. Thank you for your market guidance.
Thank you. Thanks, Stan.
Good afternoon.